Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today's video will be my top 7 tips on how to grow long, healthy hair. And before we get started, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Tip number 1 is to look after your scalp. Scalp health is so important because hair growth takes place at the roots, right? So you want to make sure that the hair that is growing out is going to be at its healthiest state from the very beginning. So one way you can have a nice, healthy scalp is by doing scalp treatments. I absolutely love the Innate Life Scalp Treatment. This is loaded with tons of hair growth ingredients such as castor oil, coconut oil, rosemary, peppermint oil, and it also has tea tree oil, which is antimicrobial. This will also prevent dandruff or other scalp problems. So to do a scalp treatment, I like to put this on my scalp before I shower. So how I apply the scalp treatment is I first part my hair down the middle, and just using a small pea-sized amount, I just massage it in my scalp, and then I section my scalp on the side. I do a couple sections, and I just use a couple pea-sized amounts throughout my whole scalp, so you only need a little bit, especially if you have fine hair like mine. And then I just massage it all in. You want to leave it in your hair for about an hour or so, and then you just shampoo out as usual. And because I use so little, I only have to shampoo once, but if you feel like there's still oil in your hair, some people prefer to shampoo twice. And then I also like to do an apple cider vinegar rinse when I do the scalp treatments, and that just ensures that it washes all the oil out of my hair. Additionally, apple cider vinegar has a lot of great hair benefits, and it's also really good for your scalp. So in addition to doing the scalp treatment, I also love hair rinses, and I do them pretty often, almost every week. So I always use apple cider vinegar as the base, and then I will add some herbs. Sometimes I do rosemary. Lately, I've been loving lavender and lavender vanilla, so you can play around and see what works best for your hair and also see what scents intrigue you. Additionally, you can make your own DIY scalp treatment. You can use any oils of your choice, and you can add some essential oils like rosemary, peppermint, tea tree, lavender. They are all really great for scalp health. Additionally, it's very important to clarify your scalp, and so I recommend a great clarifying shampoo. One of my favorites is the Herbal Shampoo by the Innate Life. It has a very fresh, invigorating lemon and bergamot scent, very gentle surfactants, and this also has a lot of great Ayurvedic herbs, which are great for hair growth, such as amla and tulsi. And it just leaves my scalp feeling clean and refreshed. So when your scalp is clarified and clean, it will help promote healthy hair growth. And now tip number 2, and that is to protect your ends. So I talked a lot about scalp health, but it's also important to take care of your ends because this is the most oldest and fragile part of your hair. And if your ends are breaking off faster than your hair is growing, it's going to make it really difficult to retain length and get the long, healthy hair that you want. So one way you can prevent breakage and keep your ends healthy, strong, lubricated, and shiny is to use a hair oil. My favorite hair oil is the Rose Elixir by the Innate Life. And so the way I like to use the Rose Elixir is I like to put it on my hair when it's damp but almost all the way dry, so maybe about 75% or so dry. And I will just put 1 or 2 drops on the very ends and just comb it in. And it just leaves my ends feeling very soft, and it helps it to retain moisture. And in addition to hair oils, you can also use leave-in conditioners. And protective hairstyles are a must for long and healthy hair. So some of my favorite tools are scrunchies. I like to do my satin scrunchies in a braid when I go to bed. And I also like to use scrunchies for ponytails, braids. I like to use scrunchies over elastics just because they're softer and they're more comfortable, and they're also less damaging for your hair. And one of my favorite tools to protect my hair is a hair stick. This is my current favorite hair stick. It's by the Brookside. It is a acrylic and resin blend with real dried flowers. And I love hair sticks because they're very gentle. I also love that this one is a nice short hair stick because although I love how it looks, I use them more for function and I don't like the stick sticking out a lot, if that makes sense. So I love doing a Nautilus bun. Sometimes I do it high, sometimes I do it low. It's really important to change up your styles. That way your roots aren't being pulled too much one way and it will prevent hair loss. And it's also good to switch things up because it's fun. So some days you could do buns, other days braids. I also really like to do space buns. And another thing I love about the space buns is it's really practical. If you have a lot of hair, it distributes the weight so it's not like one big bun. And also my friend Via on Instagram, I learned about the claw clip from her. Well, I've had claw clips in the past, but I haven't worn them in so long, and I didn't realize that they make claw clips for long and thick hair. So claw clips are a really cute way to wear your hair. And sometimes I like to create a poof and do like a rockabilly look and do headbands and do a bun or ponytail and just go for that retro look. Again, have fun with your protective styles and switch things up. And my third tip for long and healthy hair is to cut back on heat and cut back on dye. So let's touch upon heat first. So heat could be curling your hair, straightening your hair, and using a blow dryer. Now, if you do it every day, you definitely don't want to quit cold turkey, but instead of doing it every day, maybe do it every other day and then go to once a week. And then go to every other week, and so on and so forth. Now, to say you can never use heat again is not realistic. I mean, I myself use a blow dryer, especially in the winter, because I don't like to go out with cold hair. Now, I don't use a blow dryer every time I wash my hair. I try to let my hair air dry as much as possible. So this winter, I think I only used the blow dryer twice, and it was just during special occasions where I washed my hair and I didn't want to go out in the cold with wet hair. Now, some tips you can do when blow drying your hair is you can use the cool and warm settings. I would never use hot, and again, I would try and let your hair just air dry as much as possible. Now, straighteners and curling irons are much more damaging than a hair dryer just because they are directly on your hair. Make sure to use a heat protectant and really try and just save it for special occasions. Additionally, you can get flexi rods and you can do heatless curls. I have yet to use these myself. And now to get into dye, anytime you dye your hair, you are chemically changing the structure of your hair. Bleach is the most damaging, so I do not recommend bleaching. However, if you do bleach your hair, I would definitely go to a professional rather than attempting to do it yourself because they have it down to a science. They're mixing the right numbers and they really know what they're doing. Additionally, if you do bleach or dye your hair, I recommend doing a lot of hair treatments and just giving your hair a little more tender, loving care. And I also recommend doing apple cider vinegar rinses because if you use bleach, it has a very high pH. And so the apple cider vinegar helps to bring it down. And it's also worth noting, if you don't like the smell of apple cider vinegar or you're looking for an alternative, you can also get the Neroli Hair Primer by the Nate Life. This contains apple cider vinegar and it just helps to balance your hair's pH and make your hair soft and shiny. And if you do want to change your hair color, it's worth looking into natural and organic hair dyes and also henna. And tip number four is to trim your split ends. This can be a very difficult step for a lot of people because when you want to grow your hair very long, it can often feel counterproductive to trim your hair because you want to hang on to every growth and just cherish your progress. I totally get that. However, trimming is very important because as your ends start to split, it can lead to hair breakage. And I can assure you that there's no magical miracle product out there or hair mask that is going to completely get rid of splits. Yes, it can temporarily mend your split ends together. However, the only way to get rid of splits is to cut them off. And so it's recommended to get your hair trimmed every 4 to 6 months if you are growing your hair out. That's what I did. I even would go every 3 months sometimes, just because my hair is more on the fine side, and so I'm just prone to getting more split ends. Now, if you have more thick and coarse hair, you can definitely go longer. And also, the shorter your hair is, the less split ends you're likely to get. Because remember, the longer your hair is, the more fragile it is, and it's just prone to breaking at some point, right? And so it's really good to just see what works best for you. It might be every 3 months, or it might be once a year. Now, one way you can extend how often you get trims is you can do what's called search and destroy. And so I just got a pair of hair cutting scissors. These are Conair. I believe they were about $8. And so I will link it on Amazon. But these are just great, and just make sure when you get scissors that they're made for your hair and only your hair. You don't want to use craft scissors, kitchen scissors, as that can definitely damage your hair. But all you want to do is you can just take a section of hair, you can just twist it, and then you can cut off any part that's split. So you don't have to cut off every hair that sticks out. It's inevitable there's going to be some hairs. But you'll see a split, usually it's like a V shape. And you can just do that. You can also braid your hair and cut off it that way. Or you can do the fold method where you just fold your hair and you just keep going down and then you just cut off the splits that way. So there's multiple ways to do it and you just gotta find what works best for you. And tip number 5 is to know thy hair. So this tip was inspired by Socrates, the father of philosophy. And so he said that you need to know thyself in order to understand yourself and just what you need in life, right? And so with hair, there's definitely a philosophy, and it's not true for everyone. So you've got to know thy hair and know what your hair needs. So how do you know thy hair? Some things that you can look for are knowing your hair type, paying attention to your scalp. Is it oily? Is it dry? Is it normal? Is it pretty balanced? You know, do you get dandruff? Do you have seborrheic dermatitis? So on and so forth. And pay attention to your hair type and texture. Is it straight, wavy, curly? Is it thin? Is it thick, coarse? And also pay attention to your hair's porosity. So I do have a video that I can link for you that goes more in depth about porosity, but porosity refers to how your hair is able to retain that moisture. Additionally, knowing protein and moisture balance and knowing when you need protein, when you need moisture, and also using emollients is very helpful. And emollients are basically fats, oils, butters. So there's a bunch of different ways you can attack this. You can follow the capillary schedule. You can follow the PEH balance program. My friend Alexandra runs that. And I tend to follow a very intuitive approach, and I just kind of know what my hair needs based on how it feels and based on how I'm feeling. So there's no right or wrong way to find your routine. And also pay attention to how often you might need to wash. For me, it's every 2 to 3 days, preferably every other day. Other people can go every 3 or 4 days. Some people can go a week or longer. Again, it depends on your hair type and what's most comfortable for you. And I prefer natural products. I find sulfate-free and silicone-free work the best for my hair. And so here are just some of my favorite products. And I did mention the Innate Life earlier, their herbal shampoo, scalp treatment, rose elixir. I also really love Aqua Blue. Their lavender vanilla shampoo and conditioner is my favorite. And I really like Maple Holistics as well. I'm using their silk set and just kind of alternating between all of these three at the moment. And you know, this definitely takes a lot of patience and trial and error, but after a while, you will really get to know your hair and know what your hair needs, right? Because you can watch so many YouTube videos and even some of my videos and just think, oh, you know, this does not work for me. And that's okay. I know at times it can seem really frustrating, but I can assure you in the end, you will find what your hair needs. Just give it some time. It might take weeks, it might take months, and it might even take years. It's taken years for me to really know what my hair needs. But now I can rest assured. And tip number 6 is to eat a balanced diet. But what I mean by balanced diet is I would not single out any food groups, right? So I would eat your fruits, I'd eat your vegetables, you know, your grains, your carbohydrates, your starches, your proteins, and nuts. And so if you want to grow long and healthy hair, I do not recommend restricting your caloric intake, especially if you are young, because you need that to grow and develop. And so the main thing is make sure you're eating enough calories. And on the opposite end, you do not want to be binging either and eating too much calories, because that can really throw off your hormones and that can lead to hair loss. Which brings me to tip number 7, and that is to balance your hormones. And that is true for both men and women. So for women, a lot of times the estrogen is too high. I know for myself, I have a lot of signs of high estrogen. So the way I like to balance my hormones is I take Vitex and DIM every day. And so these supplements have helped me tremendously. I don't get that hormonal hair loss. I don't have as much PMS symptoms. I don't have as much PMS acne breakouts. It really helps your skin. And it just helps my mood and keeps me feeling stable. Now there are a bunch of other hormonal imbalances. Sometimes females can have too much testosterone, and as always I recommend going to a doctor, and I'm a big fan of naturopaths. I always love getting second opinions, and I like seeking both traditional medicine and alternative and just bridging the two worlds. And even for males, if you have a testosterone imbalance, it can affect the DHT, and that can lead to a lot of male pattern hair loss as well as female balding. So you see it in both men and women, although you tend to see that more in men. And men can also have too much estrogen as well. And I do realize I have quite a bit of male followers and subscribers, and a portion of you are growing your hair out. If you are interested, I would love to make a male edition, how to grow long hair. So let me know down below. And for my ladies, if you want to know a little bit more about how I balance my hormones each month and what I do in more specific, let me know below. I'd be happy to make a video. But thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what tip you found most helpful, or if you found anything new. And if you have additional tips you'd like to share, please leave them down below. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, guys, peace, love, and long and healthy hair. And I'll see you on my next video. Bye, guys!